Happy Monday, teachers, and welcome to this week's 2-Minute Teacher Tip with Susan. So when you're going to start a new lesson with your students, a new topic, do you make sure that they're hungry for it? What I mean is, when you prepare a meal, think about all of the different things that make a meal interesting for people who are going to eat it. First of all, it's going to involve the senses. It's going to taste good. It's going to smell good. It's going to look good. It's going to evoke an emotion, like a feeling of warmth or security, care, but also anticipation, surprise, satisfaction, and pleasure. And the most important thing when we're going to feed people is we want to make sure that they're hungry. If they've been snacking all afternoon, or maybe they're kind of sleepy, or they're bored of eating the same old thing, they're not going to come to the table with an appetite. So we're going to stimulate that appetite with the Wonderwall. Yes, Wonderwall, like I wonder. It can be virtual using Padlet or some such app, or it can be in the real classroom. This is how it works. You start off your topic, not in that boring way by saying, children, today we're going to talk about, no, we're going to instead start off with a really interesting thought-provoking passage from a book, or a really thought-provoking video, an interesting series of images, or even music. Then you give the students 5 minutes and a pile of colorful sticky notes to then write as many questions as possible as they have about that topic. There's no good questions or bad questions. There's just their questions. And at that point, after 5 minutes, they will cover their real or virtual wall with questions that they can then stand up and look at and read. And one question is gonna stimulate another question, another thought. It's going to surprise them. They're gonna say, oh, look, we had the same idea, giving them that sense of belonging, or, oh my gosh, I'd never thought of that. Or even better, oh, you know, that question made me think of another one. Teacher, can I write another one? Of course. And you, teacher, you go up there, you give meaning to it. Reading those questions, delighting in their ability to just travel with their minds. The best kinds of lessons are the ones where the kids go home and keep thinking about something because they haven't satisfied this desire to know. And so they come back and they say, you know what, teacher, because we weren't able to answer that question, I went home and I looked up this other information. Ah, then you know that you have created the magic. Try it to believe it. Let me know how it works and have a fantastic week. All my best to you.